In impasse terms, Skaggy is on a smoke break.
Yeah. All right, we're live. Session 21. Figure out what the hell we're.
No, not you. Then they go away. Go away. Go away. You're making me.
I am Godric, your awesome tackling bard.
I am Skaggy, the chaotic dwarf wizard.
I am Carr.
Alnor, half elf druid.
And all the turtles are kind of.
And Retosh, the half orc barbarian. And we are awesome, Carr, because we're actually still in the story.
So salty.
So we are awesome.
I told you he was salty. Alright, Kelly, tell us what the hell happened last session.
I'm Kelly, the guy hiding behind the maps, the one hosting it, creating the world and seeing how it goes. So, last time you had the showdown, Carr had been paralyzed, and pirate captain had kind of whisked him off to another area and taken off all of his armor and weapons, and he was laying paralyzed in a bed. Godric and Skaggy managed to make their way up there to see him, make sure he was okay. Skaggy managed to get 3 potions, one of which he was hoping was a neutralized paralyzation or remove paralyzation. He poured the other 2 into random drinks and gave them to the pirates and wished for luck and went up and fed the other one to Carr and then cast a fireball, which caught the whole room on fire. So as Carr is recovering, the room is burning down around him. They managed to set off the big old fight with the pirates. After several...
you guys can thank me later for saving the day and everything. It's okay. I got him.
After several amazing moves by Carr and maybe some not so good moves.
Drop the mic.
Some awesome rolls by Eleanor again. You guys managed to defeat the pirates, though the inn is now on fire, probably going to catch the webs on fire and set the rest of the town ablaze.
You are
just leaving the inn. You're all one group, and I think you're trying to figure out where to go. So you have... Karn Rikon, the spider lady who is probably coming back to talk to you. You have Weston, Jess, and Patience, along with 8 children hiding out in the other inn, the Blackfly Pub. It's more of a pub than an inn, sorry.
Her dad's there too, right? Her dad and her mom, or the innkeeper, whatever?
Weston was there with the kid.
Yeah.
And
no, there was another when we walked into the inn that he was crying over his wife.
No, that's a different building. Yeah. That's a different building. That was in the store, shopkeep.
Dang it.
And that's about where you guys are at. So you're standing just outside, deciding where to go, and that's where we're going to pick it up again. I think you had cast several of your healing spells, so many of you are still injured, but not close to death.
Yeah, how
no longer bleeding out.
Eleanor, you cast a healing spell for me.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I talked with the GM. We got it all covered. I'm good.
Okay, cool.
Okay. So
thanks for healing us and not being there.
The ghost heal. Yeah. You just
and, his and you healed Skaggy and rolled like 70-something%. So
actually, that's okay. I heard it rolled.
I was pretty sad about it. We were hoping for the bald twins, but it didn't work out.
All right. So we dragged the captain out so he could be feasted on by spiders. We looted him, right? I don't know if you ever determined what we got from that, but
I think that was part of what we need to talk about. But we also are we rewinding a little bit? I just want to know where we're at.
You're right outside the inn. You've just looted him. You have a bunch of stuff in your possession, Ritosh, that you took from a room. You haven't looked through it all yet. You grabbed some papers, grabbed some small boxes, and just kind of looted anything that looked good in the in about 30 seconds. Carr has his armor. It's in his arms. He's not wearing it yet.
It's wrapped in a...
He has no weapons, though.
Other than the two daggers
he stole from the tabletop. Which that I think are supposed to be Skaggy's.
Thanks, Skaggy.
Skaggy.
Hey,
go somewhere.
Hey, I'm not gonna use that the daggers. Much. Those daggers fucking rocked.
If I remember, the captain had a
they were
talk. Yeah, they were awesome.
Yeah, they worked way better for you than they ever did for me, man. I can keep up.
It's like it's auto plus five, right? Every time,
yeah.
As long as you hit each hand.
Yeah, it was like plus five or plus six or something like that.
You
know, yeah.
Max damage on both.
Yeah.
Yeah. So I went. I rolled a 20 for one, a natural 20, and then I rolled like a 17, then rolled
a four,
and then I got plus five because it's a D4. Then rolled a, and then I automatically got five. So then I got 18 total hit points.
Yeah.
Oh, jeez.
Yeah. With two daggers.
With two daggers.
You took him out. Bullshit.
Yeah.
So, back
nobody's
to
bitter,
the
though.
Uncomfortable situation that we had at the end of the last game. I say, hey, this fucking village is burning to the ground. I'm getting the fuck out of here. You guys go grab your treasure and let's go. If you want to evacuate people, bring them with us. I'm meeting you at the edge of town because I can't help you carry it. Fucking treasure chest. So I'll meet you on the edge of town, and I just start going.
Hold on, before do I have like leather pants or something that I wear under my armor?
No. Have you ever got leather pants? No, you have.
I didn't know. Like, I didn't know if I had some kind of like. Some kind of jean or
you have leather,
cotton pants, or something underneath.
I had
armor.
Actually told you, yes, you did have a. It's kind of a leather suit that goes underneath the plate.
Yeah, that's what I thought.
You're trying to be like Godric, huh? Just playing. Look,
no. No. Pimp suit, bitch suit.
Whatever.
So you aren't completely naked like they were the first time they met.
Aw, that's no fun now. Those moves are way cooler if I was naked.
Yeah, he does like a 300 jump in the air with the daggers and like a little dong is just flailing behind him.
Little dude, come on.
I mean, it's big to me, but like proportionally wise, you know.
John's been thinking about this.
Yeah, John's been thinking about the blue car dong.
This is really vivid in my mind based on your description, John. I mean, it's like you've been thinking about it, dreaming about it or something.
Are you visualizing the air just rushing past it, Ritosh?
Oh, this is devolving really quickly. Okay. So, I'm leaving.
Why do I play with you guys?
I'm walking out of town.
So, Godric's starting to head for the edge of town.
Yep.
Anybody going with him? Who's starting to head for the
pub?
I think
Skaggy was going with him.
It's up to John.
So what you doing, Skaggy?
I'm looking at the group and I'm gonna say I don't like this town. I want to get out of here as fast as possible. I'm gonna go get these kids and I'm getting them to safety.
Hey, can you take my armor with you?
I can. Really, it's going to take me like 30 minutes to put it on with help. So, like, you know what I mean? Like, it's pointless for me to just carry it around in my sack with me the whole time.
Where are you going?
I'm going back to the inn. Or
that's
pub.
Where Skaggy said he was going. He was going to the pub, too.
I thought you were leaving.
He said he's going to get the kids.
Oh, he's getting the kids. Okay, never mind. Man, we just started this shit and you're already not listening.
Well, because last week you weren't going.
Yeah, we've been a little bit of rewind here, but that's fine.
Godric's still an asshole.
Nothing to do.
Eleanor?
Skeggy is not happy with this shit. Let me be very clear. Spiders and giant wasps that are making people paralyzed. Like, I'm just thinking one more sting.
Yeah.
And our group.
And he gave into the pressures of Retox and understood that this is a game we need to be together in. And Godric does not care.
Ma'am, one more sting. One more sting from one of these wasps, and our group is screwed, man. Where are we going to get the potion from? So
did you use all of the potion?
Yeah, man, I dumped that whole thing in there. I mean, he's a big dude, you know. This is like drinking, you know, this is like taking a little shot of something.
Yeah.
So Halinor is not too worried because he saw the wasp up close, and it wasn't doing any damage to either of us.
Nothing happened. The door was the winner.
That's right. I'm more worried about the doors here.
If you missed the reference, please go back and watch two episodes ago where the most valuable player was the door.
Yeah, it really was.
The door frame, to be exact.
And that was a kick-ass door frame.
Yeah, Carr was talking about forging his weapons from the blood of his enemies, so I asked him if his weapon was going to be forged of, like, oak or mahogany or something.
So, Halinor, which way are you going? You going out of town with Godric, or are you going to go back to the kids, or are you going to pick something else?
I am going to head back to the kids.
And Ritosh?
I put my arm around Skaggy. I'm like, you did the right thing. And then I kind of look at Godric. I'm like, shake my head.
Dude, I'm already walking. Like, I'm like in the distance.
Okay, then I turn around and I go.
Hey, Godric.
So, you guys are starting to head over. And you're getting close to the end, and the fire's starting to spread, and you see it starting to catch some of the stuff and spreading a little bit, some of the webs, and all of a sudden four spiders come charging at you. But then you see coming over the roof of the pub a fifth spider, and it is huge, the size of a pony.
You
and it starts agitating, and the other spiders run away. Ooh. And the big spider goes back over the far side of the Black Fly pub.
It's gonna be that chick. Wait, do we recognize the spider?
No, you don't recognize the spider.
As it seems, it's not that queen one that was.
No,
she wasn't dead. So
she was hurting though.
It was hurt. Exactly. That's why I'm asking.
Yeah.
No, I'm betting it's going to be...
Or it's going to be the other chick.
Yeah. I'm betting it's a were spider and it's going to be one of the other characters. The question is who. So, if there's still these spiders coming around, they're still going after humans. These kids still need protection. So, I am still going to head over there and make sure that they're safe.
Okay.
I'll head towards the large spider and try to see where it went.
Okay. You're running around the far side of the building.
Mm-hmm.
Skaggy is going inside. Ritosh and Carr.
I'm going to try to knock down some of the webs.
Okay, around
so that way they don't spread to the pub.
Okay. Ritosh?
I see Halinor walk off and I'm kind of just... I'm not following, like, walking exactly with him, but I'm kind of just, like, watching him kind of...
Okay.
So behind. He's...
All right.
I want to see Carr roll to see if he can actually cut down these webs with his dagger.
I said knock them down. Not did I say cut them.
So, Skaggy goes inside, and you see Jess and Patience there, along with all the kids.
So I go to Jess and Patience and I say, yeah, what happened since I left?
Not a whole lot. We've just been waiting here, but we smell smoke. What's going on?
Yeah, so the there was a fight with pirates. I did what I had to do to survive, and I used a fire spell. It was all I had left in my arsenal. It was the only thing I could do. But I'm not confident that this town is going to survive. Wait. As I say this, Kelly, where are the kids at?
Kind of around you.
Okay, so hold on a second. Hold on a second.
No rewind.
He never told me the kids were there. He only told me Jess and Patience were there.
I thought I said them all. And the kids.
All right. So I'm gonna say so there was a battle with the pirates. Some things happened. Some of us have regrets. The evil pirates are vanquished, and the ship is what's burning right now. And I kind of look at them, you know, and I'm like trying to give them like I'm just trying to like focus just on them and be like, you know.
Oh.
Smoke.
Oh. So wow.
Jess and Patience turn to each other and they're talking real quiet but intense. Like we better get the kids out of here then, right?
Yes.
So they start rounding up the kids and getting what they can, and Jess has got his bow and grabbing his arrows. The patient seems to be grabbing a couple things from beneath the from around the bar and stuff, and they're getting all the kids wrapped up and ready to head out. leading the way. And as they're doing that, Halinor has gone around and doesn't see anybody. The spider appears to be gone.
Are there any indications of tracks or anything, or is it pretty hard to tell?
Go ahead and roll a 20 and see how good we do.
Oh, God, here we go. And so it begins.
It starts early.
40. What?
How about six?
Yeah, you're not so great at tracking.
Okay. Surprise.
You come up upon Halinor, and he seems to be looking around at the ground and up in the trees. And
yeah, I'm going to try to
kind of poke behind a bush.
I'm going to try to see if I notice anything since I see him looking around too.
Okay. Go ahead and give yourself a roll. You can add your perception.
Oh! He sees all the things.
Ooh!
You see everything! Yeah.
That is a much smarter work than we all would have thought.
Your third eye opens, you see the universe and its, you know, entirety.
So what you notice is some boot tracks that come out from the door of the pub, and they go around kind of by a tree, and they end about 4 feet from where the tree is.
Okay, so I'll follow it and just kind of look up into the tree to see if I see anything.
Looking up, you don't see anything. No.
So I'll tell them how to
a couple other weird tracks, though. More like circles, like pegs or posts or something.
Like spider legs?
Yeah, that could be it.
Okay.
Tracks from that lead to the tree from where the feet used to be.
Is this like a big tree?
Yeah. It goes up, there's webs coming from the town that are kind of stuck to it and everything.
Oh, okay. Okay.
It's just at the edge. The pub was at the edge of the forest, and this is the backside.
So I pointed out to Halinor. I'm like, Halinor, what do you think?
So, what I think about what? I'm not sure. I don't see anything. What are you talking
about? Well, the spider tracks just disappeared. Like, I don't know. I'm not sure what's going on. It looks like the feet turn into spider legs, and then they just run off. So let's go back to the inn and see what's going on.
You want to go back in and follow these tracks? Because I can see the tracks.
They kind of disappear at the tree. So.
Oh.
Yeah, I think it's good. Just go back and get with everyone. That's where I'm going to
head. Is this tree something we can climb?
Well, anybody with a strength greater than 9 could probably climb it.
Anybody that does not have the strength of a child. When I say child, I mean like 3-year-old.
All right, so you're still looking, trying to figure out if you can pull yourself up the tree, but Helen or Ritosh is walking back in. You gonna follow him in, or are you gonna keep messing at the tree?
Let's try to climb.
You're trying to climb. Okay, go for a 20.
Excellent.
God. Yeah. You wrap around the tree with all of your weight and wrap your legs around it and slowly slide down until you're sitting on the ground.
I look at my shoulder and I'm glad that Ritosh did not see me. So I quick dust myself off and I turn around and head back to the inn.
Okay. Hey, give another perception check, Ritosh. Roll your 20.
Ritosh.
Oh!
Yeah, you saw him, but you chose to ignore. At least for now. So, awesome. Yeah, you saw him sitting on the ground holding the base of the tree. So you two go back in and you find the kids all getting into a line and Patience is about to lead them out and
I go
Jess is at the back of the line with his bow and he's got an arrow knock. And
I'm gonna grab both of you guys and like try to pull you down so I can whisper into your ears and I'm telling you what's going on, and I'm also saying, like, try not to scare the kids, you know? And then I also say, we need some help with the C-H-E-S-T-S. Because I can't carry that, and the other kids can't carry that.
They got pockets. Fill them up. Oh, wait, I'm outside. Never mind.
You are not.
I just said that.
So I'm going to ask Jess and Patience where Weston is. Weston
said he stepped out about 15 minutes ago.
I think you guys need to come clean with us. What are you not telling us? Why did those pirate guys attack us?
Well, they probably didn't want to know the secret of the town, but do you really want to talk about all that right now, or should we get out of the burning town first?
Touche.
No, you should sit in the burning town and tell you about it, Ritosh.
Is it like coming like fast? Really?
The thing is, when it catches the webs, it kind of goes, whoosh, you know, it's almost like a fuse, and flies along the webs to the next place.
All right.
So
buildings are just like randomly going up as we're sitting here.
Yeah.
And then all right, let's go, kids.
I'll sheath my weapons and then grab the two chests. So I'm basically encumbered, I think.
Yeah. So I would suggest that Halinor and I lead the way. We're going to go off in the direction that Godric went. And Ritosh, you should probably follow behind us.
Yep.
Meanwhile, Godric, you're at the edge of town. you've made it beyond the webs a little bit. You find a nice little clearing, and you slashed enough of the brush that you think they'll be able to follow you. And you're sitting there, and you hear footsteps approaching you.
Yeah, I immediately draw my weapon and turn around.
And there is Adriana. She's quickly approaching you, and she says, "I smell smoke, and I could see some fire. Where are the children?"
"The children are meeting us here. They're in the inn, and they're being accompanied by Carr and the gang, whatever we call ourselves."
Wouldn't the more appropriate response be, "I don't know, I don't care"?
Weren't you over there helping him?
I was coming over here to make a fire, you know, because we're going to sit here and make some food for the children while they're over, you know, trying to get us. Obviously, the town's burning. I don't want to be in a burning town. I was trying to get them out quickly, so I'm setting up base camp here. So we can regroup and figure out what we're doing from there.
Let's see, what's your... I'm going to give you a chance to roll to see whether you can convince her with your tale. It's not sounding that convincing to me, but maybe you're doing better with her. I think you have deception. Why don't you go ahead and roll? You have a deception ability, which you have a pretty dang good bonus on.
Why does that not sound plausible, Kelly?
Because you were sitting on your ass, not setting up camp.
No, you did not let me say I was setting up camp. You said I walk into the edge and I hear some noise, footsteps, and I immediately draw my weapon. Obviously, I did not have time.
Okay.
Godric, there's only one thing you need to know, man. The horse. Kelly does not care about our group. He does not care.
You mean that?
He has no emotion. He has no emotion for us.
Right,
he's
I'm
he's like
make
a robot.
Legit roll, even though that's what I was legit going to do. But okay, I'll roll it. Yes, 22.
Damn it.
Fuck you, Kelly.
Didn't he need to roll a 30?
Yeah.
Well, it's just versus what she rolled, so you don't know what her insight score is.
Whatever. This is bullshit.
So anyway, she...
Can I roll the support?
I'm
going to
go help
too.
Her. And she leaves and heads down your little path. And in a few minutes, the rest of the group is there, and I think you decide you're still a little bit close to town, and maybe you should find a next place just a little bit further.
Isn't and the other next in, place like a day's out or something, Kelly?
No, just knows of a place, he said, that has a little bit of a rock shelter that you could put your backs to, and there's a fire pit there. He's used it when hunting before. It's just a little ways away, and it's out of any danger from anybody from the town finding you or without doing some serious hunting, and it's not going to burn down.
I want to know what direction that is. Like, is that towards the keep? Is it towards this orc sword thing that we were doing a while back? Like, what direction is this taking us?
It is... So, you're currently north of the keep by, you know, 2 days, and this would be maybe 15, 20 minutes southwest of where you're at right now. Not very far off your end.
Sounds like a good place
good
to go
place
to try
rest.
To figure out what's going on.
You guys all are fairly exhausted. You need some place anyway to try and get some sleep and get spells back. And
yep.
But you probably don't want to do it 100 yards from the burning town.
Right. Yep. No, it sounds good to me.
This isn't a half a day's march or anything. It's a little ways away, but not
No, it sounds fine to me. I just wanted to make sure it was in a. It wasn't going to take us away from where we were trying to go.
So,
did we find Godric, or are we just going?
Yes. You got Godric. You're all reunited.
I'm waving my hands in the bar, you know, the tree line. Guys, this way.
And it's late in the day. You spent all that time down the dungeon and stuff, and so it's almost nightfall by the time you guys are setting up the camp there, and Patience managed to grab some cheese from behind the bar and a few bottles of something else. You find one of them's looks like it might be a rum, and a couple of them looks like it might be beer. So it's kind of
being all thematic tonight.
Did you say Adriana disappeared on us? Like, she disappeared on me? She just went back into the woods?
Sorry. I was still knocking down spider webs and was never included in anything.
Oh, so we left Carl behind.
You guys just walked and left me down.
No,
where did everybody go?
Car, I don't think there's anybody, you know, like less perceptive than you. Like, it's like a battle between you and Halinor here.
I don't know. Halinor is a druid and couldn't find anything in the woods. Okay, let's just pull that shit out. I mean.
Okay, so Halinor still takes the cake. Gotcha.
Yeah, I mean.
So Carr, there's eight kids there. When they were leaving the inn, seeing the things burning and all of that, they would have made plenty of noise. You would have caught on. If you really want to stay, keep knocking webs down. But otherwise, I assume you followed.
Yeah, I did. I'm just kidding.
Oh, Carr, we hardly knew ye, cutting down spider webs with a naked dong.
Hey, it's long enough. Might as well do it. Hey, at least I can get it up.
So, you never answered me, Kelly. Did Adriana just disappear in the woods, creepily?
No. No, she joined up with all the kids, and she's with the kids, making sure, taking care of them. And a few minutes as you were down, you heard a little bit more crashing and turned around, and Weston was there following, joining up, running up behind you. So,
okay. Well, as we're walking, you know, the mile or two on our journey, I'm going to ask Adriana, you know, where's the queen? She's, you know, back there. What's going on with that?
She said, can we talk after supper, once the kids are asleep?
Sure.
So you guys managed to get the kids fed with some of the cheese and some of the other rations, and getting them all kind of squirreled away for the night, and then you're kind of sitting around the fire.
I'm going to use the prestidigitation. I'll never be able to pronounce that right.
The magic trick, yes.
Yeah, I'm going to use the magic trick to entertain the kids.
Okay. You do that for a little bit, and once she says, okay, Uncle Skeggy, you're going to have to let them get to sleep now. And they kind of get them off, and they're off to the side and asleep, and later she comes by the fire and says, I think we all need to talk.
Couldn't agree with you more.
So, you had a question earlier, Godric?
Yeah, where were you? What happened with the queen? What the hell is going on in this town? Like, all we know is we burnt the shit to the ground because pirates were trying to keep us in this town. They declared martial law. There's chaos. We have no idea what's going on. Where the hell have you been?
She went back to see the queen, and the queen did not survive. She's all that's left of the nest. The queen's last wish was that the children get moved somewhere to safety. And so that's going to be her duty.
So I say
Weston seems fairly shaken up by that news as well.
So I say you're a were-spider?
She takes a big sigh, looks you square in the eye, and says yes.
And I look at Weston and I say, I presume you as well.
He looks over at her and she kind of nods and said, yes, we're the last two of our kind. We're the last two of the nest.
So these kids aren't were-spiders?
No.
Why did the queen care so much about them? Beginning to safety then.
Weston had said that and Adriana goes, yes, they are the queens. Queen's brood, they are.
Wait, they are were-spiders?
Weston looks down and shakes his head, and he's like,
Daddy, do you already have my bottle?
Why are you so
curious? What do these kids wake up?
The kids just woke up, dude. It was like, hey. They said, Daddy, you have my shit? Give it to me.
I said little Timmy, that was just drinks? A I said little Timmy, drink? That was just a magic trick.
Is that a bottle of rum or what?
You want your bottle of rum back.
I want to as I'm smelling a lot of bullshit and it's not, you know, Carr's body odor. I'm going to go talk to Jess.
Well, Jess is right there, too. His eyes are about as big as 50-cent pieces. He's just as a large platinum piece.
I'm assuming I would be standing next to Stanley because, you know, that's how we roll. And I would kind of lean into him and go, there's a lot of something going on. I don't believe the queen just died.
So, Jess. Yeah, what do you... Go ahead with what... Jess seems pretty startled about this whole thing.
And so, doesn't say anything to me.
And Patience looks like she can't quite figure out what's going on.
So I say, who are these pirates?
Yeah, what's the secret of the town?
He goes, this town, there's a pirate, and he got into a battle with the mage, and somehow his ship got teleported here, along with all the treasures. He buried the treasure somewhere near the town, or so the legends say. It's too far from the sea to get back to anywhere, so he and his crew became brigands. They became bandits. And everybody who lives in the town, almost everybody, now has to serve the captain. And it's been a tradition for almost 200 years, though nobody's ever found the treasure. And they loot.
As Carr is stroking the chest.
They loot the caravans, and there's a group that was gone, so that's not the entire town. Half the men were gone, and they'll be returning in a few days. Nobody knows exactly when, because that's part of the reason I wanted to leave town. They made me go on two raids, and I don't want to do that. That's not who I am. That's not what I want to be. And so I had to leave the town, but I couldn't go. I would have left before the first one, but I couldn't leave Patience.
So the
pirate was alive. Yeah, go ahead.
No, you go ahead. You ask.
So the pirate was alive for 200 years?
No. The pirate, Captain Havera, was the one who formed the town.
Right. Oh, okay. And then the pirates have
and then Gale,
for they just running the town.
for eight generations, the people there may have been pirates, they may not have been, but really they're land, they're brigands for the most part. They're land bandits. They carry on the tradition of pirates more than... Now, the two old guys that you saw probably actually were pirates. They just ended up here.
Did the pirates know that you guys were were-spiders?
No, that's a secret that we kept within town. Nobody knew. Jess didn't know. Patience didn't know.
But the pirates seemed okay with the spiders.
The Galen, he used to use spider eaters on their raids. They would ride them into battle when they were raiding caravans. Hang on one second.
Typing secret messages to somebody.
Not to me.
Oh, I heard somebody shit pin. Oh. Who was it? Who was it? Halinor? Yeah. What are you doing, Steve? What are you reading?
Ba-ba-boom.
Yeah.
I'm back, I hope.
Uh-huh. Hmm.
You guys still there?
Yeah. Yes. We know you're talking.
Now we got... And now we got... Keeping going on.
So there's still there's still some things that aren't adding.
There's a whole lot of gaps in this story.
Yeah, there's some things that still aren't adding up for me. So
why don't you just leave the town?
Our kind values remaining hidden. And we had set up the nest, and we were apart. But then, a few generations ago, some of them started going and visiting the humans, and they actually liked it. It was an exciting life for them. Not all of our kind do, but some did. And so they would go and set up and live within the town. Others would remain within the nest. But we always kept our secret. Those within the town, most of them did not choose the bandit lifestyle. But as Jess said, to prove your loyalty, you would have to go on a raid or two. Then they would usually let you know, some would become an innkeeper or the keeper of a pub or serve in some other capacity. But we valued the secret of our as well. We valued the secret of our nest and the secret of the town. That's the main thing we had in common with the brigands, is that they valued the secret of the town. Nobody knew where their base was.
Your nest was set up in a wasp's or a bee kill or a spider killer's lair?
No, it wasn't. He sent those in. Captain Galen sent those in to kill out the were spiders so that he could search it for the treasure.
Gotcha. So remind me again, who was the guy whose wife passed away?
He was
I'm just asking
the storekeeper.
I'm just asking you, Kelly. I'm not asking like the characters in the story.
So that was the storekeeper's wife who got killed.
Right. So I'm gonna ask about the storekeeper if they knew him and know what happened to his wife.
We already know this.
There were some arguments in town. Galen was sending his thugs around, and they were going through people's homes. And I objected, and I got thrown in a... And this is Weston speaking, and he got thrown in a barrel.
And he knew you were a spider.
That Galen knew that I was? No.
Yeah. No.
Okay. No. He just knew there were a nest of spiders there. He did not know her true form.
So it was it was coincidence that he locked you in a barrel in a room with one of those spider killers.
Not coincidence. He was just trying to keep anybody from saving me or me from getting out. Those wasps were just like, imagine him as a trained guard dog. Imagine him as a huge guard dog, if not.
That's true. I mean they did paralyze Carr after all.
Speaking of, doesn't Skaggy have like three of these on his person?
Have what?
The wasp eggs. Don't you have like three of them or four of them?
So that was the thing. It's funny you said that because I was actually preparing to say that, like, I lean over to you and whisper to you, like, dude, we got these fucking eggs. So like I'm kind of like, you know, and then I'm just like, got it wrong.
Yeah, Retosh. Remember, you have some chests and some papers and stuff that you stole.
Yep. Okay, yeah, I'm going to start looking through them. Yeah, I didn't know if we had a good time to go through that yet, because we haven't looked through the captain stuff either, right?
Oh.
Yeah. But then, do we have any more questions for them? Does everything make sense, I think? Why
she has some questions of you. She has some questions of you.
Okay.
She looks at you. She looks at all of you, and she's like, "You are a very strange assortment of people."
Says the weird spider. Okay.
Hey, man, don't be a weird spiderist.
She's like, "I would like to know, how did you guys get together? Who are you?" She looks at Retosh and she says, "I heard of your actions to save and protect the children. It was very noble. It was a very, very noble thing to do, and yet your kind is not known for their nobility. Or at least, you know, referring to the orcish half of your, you know." You tell me about.
Well, I'm a half orc, so I'm only half bad. And I was also raised by wolves, so.
Oh, so that makes you super honorable.
You're just half a badass.
These guys are like my pack now, and I just took these cubs right in. I can't just let these kids get harmed. We spent all this time trying to save them. And I'm not just going to let them burn in a fire, so.
I say, individually, we're all probably somewhat shady characters. But
no, not all of us.
We ran into each other through a set of coincidences and random circumstances. And just started traveling together. And together as a group, I think we're much more honorable than individually we would otherwise be.
So what are your goals?
In my mind right now, I'm thinking I'm gonna hatch me this fucking egg and ride this bitch into the sunset with these gold jewels hanging around my neck.
He's gonna be wearing a crown on a flying wasp with a little scepter. Fucking just flying around his keep, like, ha-ha, I won.
Skaggy's got this, like, this dream of, like, you know, dwarf wizard pimp life going on. Yeah, exactly. like, I just forget that I was even asked a question right now.
So, Skaggy's kind of rolled back his eyes, and he's looking at the fire, and, okay, so he's out of it. So she looks over at Halinor and says, "How do you, elves and orcs don't usually get along. How do you?"
Says, "Well, my family was pretty well known to be healers, and it didn't really pass to me, and I never really fit in, and these guys, the rest of the guys wouldn't know it, but I'm not always the most graceful person.
I wouldn't know it.
You don't say,
Hellgoers. She's looking around at the rest of the group, laughing at him.
You got it wrong.
Retouch is remembering from like an hour ago with like Eleanor hugging a tree.
So I hear people laughing behind me. I'm used to hearing laughter, so I just kind of ignore it because I don't really put two and two together very well. So I keep going with the story. So I turned to her like, well, I'm here to try to restore honor to my family and learn the skills I need to do so.
She looks over at Carr and says, I'm not sure that I've ever met your kind before.
Well, I'm a dragonborn. We usually don't travel this far out away from home. I was actually caught off guard and trapped, and these yahoos are the ones that actually got me out, so I feel like I owe them a debt since they got me out of a tight spot.
So are you going to continue to travel with them?
Well, for now. It's been very interesting, and these knuckleheads might seem kind of crazy and not like they have anything going for them, but at the end of the day, they are good people, and they want people to be happy and, you know, be free, do some cool shit.
And plus, Carr has never had his little dingle dangling more than on these adventures.
Feel very free.
That's right. Who's the biggest dick in the room?
She looks over at Grinkle and says, how do you join Grinkle? And she's like looking at him, and he goes, oh, me Grinkle. He goes, oh, I worship Uldimara, he god of revelry and jokes, make him smile. And he pulls out a little medallion, and it has like a smiley face on it. He goes, when he smile, he give me tricks. And then he kind of tucks it back in his shirt.
Buddy.
And he kind of looks at the rest of these guys. They make me smile.
I give Gringle what's up nod. Like, you know it. Yeah.
Found it right there.
Found it. Uldimara, he is a god of Greyhawk. He's the god of mischievousness, revelry, tricks, jokes, and thieves.
Awesome.
Hey.
So.
We all know that we have nothing in our packs.
And. She looks over at Godric.
I say, well, that was enough adventure for today. Somebody take watch. I'm going to bed. I ignore the question, and I just go and make up my bed. Yeah.
I love you how he was.
You don't want to make any more perception checks?
I know who Godric is.
Is he?
I know who Godric is. I don't need to tell this woman who Godric is.
So, she's kind of talking to Weston, and she goes, we need to find a place for the kids. And she looks at you guys and goes, we can't take them back to the town. What's left of it. And when the bandits arrive, they will be looking for revenge.
So
that's no place for her. She goes, you do seem honorable. I'd like that you are a pack. Would you take in some more misfits?
Can we tell her that we killed that band right outside of the town? Is that what they're talking about? Is that who they're worried about?
We sent those guys out. Those aren't the same guys, I don't think, were they?
Oh, okay.
They could be.
They most probably were.
You could ask Jess maybe and see whether he's.
Yeah, I'm asking Jess.
It's like, no, those are the ones that stick around town most of the time. They're kind of his right-hand man, if you will, or his picked thugs. There was a good dozen that left town.
So where did all the other spiders come from, and why wasn't anybody freaked out by that?
The little spiders?
Yeah.
So those lived in the nest with the were spiders, but they weren't intelligent. It'd be like
they're dogs. They're
dogs. Yeah, they're pets living with humans. And when somebody burned down the human's apartment house, the dogs went nuts.
Okay.
And the masters stayed and fought, and they fought the. You can tell from the way the bodies were, they fought off the wasp. But wasp did number on them.
Yeah, I don't know. I'm actually buying this story. I don't really think there's anything to really, you know, roll a check against. Like, I'm not sensing any BS here.
So, Skang, I think it's up to you to. I'm gonna whisper to you. Like, do you want? I think she's asking if we can. Give them a place to stay. Do you want them to stay at the keep?
Yeah. So I say, I've heard that an uncle of mine has a place that we could stay at. He's off on some adventures. It's well protected. There aren't many paths in. So I say we could go check that out and see. And if my uncle isn't there and he's off on adventures, we could go check it out.
Well, couldn't you just send a note with him? So, what's her name? That's actually still at the keep. We'll let in.
Yeah.
Unless you want to travel all the way back to the keep.
With them. I don't know if we need to travel with them. We can send Jess and Patience and Weston and the other girl.
So I look at our new friends here and I say, can you let us talk about this? Because I can see that like you guys are just kind of like shifting around and you're not really comfortable with what I said.
Well, I'm just going off of what you said last session. Yeah, you know what I mean?
But you can tell I wasn't being 100% truthful in everything. Like, I'm trying to hide some facts from them, right? So I don't just want to speak openly about this.
Yeah, yeah. Gotcha.
So can we have a private moment, Kelly?
Yeah. So they go back over to the kids and bunk down near the kids, leaving... just Ritosh, Halinar, Carr. If you want, you can go kick Godric and bring him back over to the fire.
I'm not sleeping. Why I'm just getting like my bunk ready. Like I'm getting my area prepped. Like I see them kind of break off, and I get curious, so I wander over.
Yeah. So I go. I don't know. I don't know if I'm 100% comfortable sending these folks to this keep. I mean, you guys tell me what your read is, you know, do you trust them? Like, I trust the story that they told us is accurate. I don't know if I still trust them.
I think I trust Jess, but well, I do not trust these were-spiners. First of all, they're very, like, half-assing everything. Like, what happened to the queen? Where are these babies from? We get one line, and we get the truth immediately after. Like, there's a lot of shadiness. I get they're trying to be secretive, society, whatever, but we just saved their lives, and they're not being straight with us. So I wouldn't trust them my own keep, is what I'm saying.
Right. Well, the thing that still doesn't make sense to me is that the queen... Why did the queen give us the wasp eggs?
Why did the queen die? We healed the queen. They didn't, she was fine.
They didn't give you the wasp eggs.
No, we cut them out.
Yeah, cut them out. Took them from.
We were trying to help
her. She wanted them out of her.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. So, I mean, what we did to her could have killed her, but if those wasp eggs hatched, those would have killed her.
Right. So, we healed her. I healed her twice. I know this for a fact.
I'm not going to get
them. She was doing okay when we left, and then Adriana left, came back, oh, the queen's dead. Very convenient. Who's the new queen?
Maybe. You'd think if she was alive, though, she would want to be taking care of her babies. They would be trying to get away from us.
I'm
and
not
having
saying she's alive. I'm not saying she is dead, but it's very mysterious on how she just died.
She was dying.
But she was dying when we left, remember? She did.
Because of the wasp.
Yeah, no, she was.
Wasp egg stuck into her.
Yeah, she was not doing well. She couldn't move, remember?
Yeah, she was like, move, but she was stabilized. Like,
yeah, but yeah, she was stabilized at that moment. But you got to realize that.
We all left her.
We left her. We didn't keep her stabilized.
And it's just convenient that we were gone for a couple hours. And Adriana goes to check her out, and then she's like, oh, she's dead. Darn.
Well,
I'm just saying.
So what's your hypothesis here?
My hypothesis is other shit is going on. Adriana killed her to become the new queen of the nest and is trying to get some shit going. I don't know. I just don't trust them.
Okay. Yeah, and I'm going to say that's not necessarily, that certainly could be the case, and I think that that's why I was saying, I trust their story that they were telling, but I don't know if I 100% trust them. And, I mean, look, you know, even if these kids are enemies, it's still kind of messed up to, you know, let them perish or whatever. We got to do something about them. That's why I was thinking... Part of me said we should travel back to the keep with them, make sure we feel comfortable with this situation, right? Because if nothing else, we could let them rest for a day or two at the keep and then send them off somewhere else.
Or we
right?
could just have Jess, because they're part of the same town, they know each other, have him. He's a hunter, a wilderness gatherer. Send them to Hamlet, let them live in a big city, and deal with it. They appear as people. They're trying to live in secret, but... They can then figure out what they're doing after that.
Right, so don't even send them to the keep as well.
What's that right. village that's out, that we went to that's right by the keep before we went to the keep? Hamlet. Was that Hamlet?
Yeah.
I didn't think that was a big village.
I mean, it's bigger than what we just came from.
Yeah, I, that's where I was going, Gaggy. We could tell Jess to take them there, and they can hang out there. We could deal with this later if we need to.
Yeah, I'm good with that. I'm good with that plan. We can always tell them that, you know, my uncle is occupying the keep. I communicated with him, and it's not available. What were you saying, Carr?
My question is, though, since their nest was underground, is their nest always underground then? Because if it is underground, couldn't they go to the keep and then have, what's her name?
Mia?
What's her name?
Mia.
Mia.
Mia. Yeah. I was thinking Maya, and I was like, that's not right. So Mia, take them to the secondary entrance, the underground entrance, and have them just build something off of that, away from the keep. But
and then just have a hydra
that way,
underneath the castle. That sounds like a great plan, Carr.
No, going the other way.
Right, but they would...
Because if they're going to build it underground anyways...
But the concern is that if they're
Here's my thing, though.
So Carr, what if this?
But she can keep an eye on them better than if they just randomly built a nest somewhere else. You know what I mean?
She could, until she's taken over by were-spiders and eaten.
Did you meet Maya? Are we talking about the same girl?
Are we talking about the same badass bitch? Yeah.
She's basically all
Are we talking about the same person?
This is a whole army of were-spiders. I don't care how badass she is. When they eventually breed like jackrabbits, and now there's 100 of them.
But it doesn't seem like they breed like rabbits.
I mean, why is it your job to, you know, give these people the rest of their lives? Yes.
My thing is,
we're putting them in a safe place. They can make with the rest of their lives what they, you know, make of it. They don't have to be spiders. They don't have to be underground.
Yeah, but I mean, like, that was my question, though. If that's where they nest like that, then if we gave them, like, an entrance to, like, then build off of, not only then you could keep an eye on them, but think about it. That already makes that secondary entrance something that if somebody does go down, you have somebody protecting it, too.
Yeah, but why do you want to keep an eye on them?
So you know what they're doing, so...
God, this photo is staked out as me?
Why do you want to keep an eye on them? We've seen them. They can be on their way.
Yeah, I think they are the type of people, though, that, like, if you did a solid for, like, they would totally
save
repay
their
it
lives
back.
And take them out of a village where they're being murdered.
Yeah,
because
like, so we could call on them and they would come help. But if we gave them a place to live, like, they would be, like, in debt, then. You know what I mean? Like, I feel like they would, like, protect that entrance forever then. You know what I mean?
Yeah, I mean, they don't seem like they're malicious, right? I mean, they've lived next to this village for hundreds of years, and it's not like they ever attacked this village. The pirate guy found out about them and decided to attack them. So it's like they're...
Yeah, they're not, like, going to raid the keep and go, oh, it's ours now. Rah!
I want to know what the old wise druid is thinking. I haven't heard from him. He's been quiet. I'm looking right at you, Halinor. No, like, well, he does have high wisdom, guys. So that was a true statement.
That's his only thing he has going.
That's his
he has a good constitution, too.
I'm also good at climbing trees, so it's fine.
He can fly, guys.
I don't know about climbing trees. Maybe hugging them, making them feel loved.
And I'm the one that comes up with this idea. Like, that's the sad part.
So as we're discussing this, I turn to the group and like, I feel comfortable with them being near the keep, but I'm also a little partial or biased because this is another people who can change shape like I can, so I tend to trust them more.
One for Carr.
Well, Carr gets one. Halinor has convinced me that his vote is worth a half a vote.
Hey, the human half.
One.
So Ritosh.
Half. I'm voting. The other city. We'll keep them there until we decide what we want to do with them when we get back.
So you're voting with Godric?
Yes.
So it's 2-1.5.
Come on.
This is your keep, so you get 2 votes.
He turns into an eagle.
So I'm the deciding vote here of what's going to happen. So I like both plans.
Well, really, it's your keep.
It's
so
your
keep. Anyway.
You're the deciding vote either way.
Right.
I like both plans.
Don't you ask Mobius?
I like both plans, but I also like...
Vote? Yeah, what about Grinkle? Yeah, what's Grinkle's vote? I like Grinkle. Grinkle,
yeah,
come on.
You Grinkle. Grinkle gets the vote. Or Mobius.
The other half.
Bring in Mobius. Talk to that bitch. What's he got to say?
All right, so let's hear Grinkle first. Grinkle, what do you think on this matter?
Kids make me smile.
So the kids That's make you smile. Carr. So does that mean you're voting with Carr?
Yeah, Carr make me smile too.
Boom!
So his whole vote, Halinor's half vote.
That's 2.5.
2.5 to 2. So my vote could still be the deciding factor here. So I say, let's see.
Do you have the spell?
So that's the thing. So that's the thing here. Let's. I'm a big fan of magic. That's my background. That's my life. That's everything that I think I hold, you know, that is true in this world. You know, I don't think there's anything that magic can't solve or help us with. So I'm going to cast a cantrip, minor illusion. And I'm going to think of both things. I'm going to think of the town, and I'm going to think of the castle. And whatever gets casted out of my wand is the deciding, is the vote.
You're going with something random to make this decision. I just want to make sure I got this right.
Yes, that's exactly. Yep.
So, just roll a dice, dude.
That's what I'm going to do. That's what I'm going to do. All
right, I just want to make sure I had this right. Okay, this is awesome. This is why you role play, right?
Yeah, exactly. So Kelly, what should I roll here? What do you think?
Roll a d4. Let's
roll a d20.
Or d6. D20.
It doesn't matter. Odd is one, even is the other.
Yeah. All right. So odd is the town, even is the keep.
This is awesome.
And since it is Kaggy,
but it's not the
master of chaos, we'll probably get in. Land on an edge.
So wait. Is Skaggy rolling this, or are you rolling this, Kelly?
Skaggy's rolling this. This is
my odd was I can pound. Roll and roll a one for you.
Halinor, join your Godric's side.
All right. Here we go. I'm gonna roll my 20.
What's what? Which one's what?
So odd, I believe I said odd was the town.
Hamlet.
And yeah. Even is the keep. Car's plan, basically. So, and by the way, really quick, before I do this, Car, if that's the deciding vote, does that mean we're going to the keep with them to get them set up down there in the tunnel?
Let's see what happens. Just roll the dice.
Well,
yeah. Here's
my thing, though. If you send a note to Maya, Maya can do it all for us.
Yep.
Okay.
She would look at it as it's another way to protect the keep, and that's what she's about. All right. You know what I mean? And let's face it, nobody's going to fuck with Maya.
Who's okay. Maya? You mean
we
Maya?
Didn't even fuck with Maya.
Mia?
Yeah. Who's Maya?
That's Maya.
Yeah,
the program lady all the time, but I don't know who she is.
All right,
you don't.
So I'm gonna roll the dice. So Kelly, do I get any modifiers? Do I get a +1 or a +2?
Yeah. If you roll even, you get a +3. If you roll odd, you get a +0. So go ahead and roll.
All right, here we go.
Come on, dude. Yes.
+3, you're at
21. So, John, you tell them that if you give them this place to live...
Before we tell them, I want to make sure that they live actually underground. Like, that's their thing. You know what I mean? Because that's their lair.
That's your whole plan, John.
I said that at the very beginning. That was at the very beginning of my plan. I'm like,
you're not allowed
if they
above
live
ground.
Underground, you're how do allowed. We do this?
You are in the dark.
That was
the trash in the cavern.
Rewind it. Somebody rewind it.
No, I know that's
somebody
what you
look
said.
At Twitch. Rewind it,
that
and it's going to say.
You know what?
I'm as the chaotic wizard. I like the fact that there is some randomness and there is unknown, and there are parts of this plan that aren't fully baked. So I say we're going forward with this. Let's do this.
In your face, Godric. In your face.
Godric's over in the corner.
I need you out!
Godric's like, fuck you guys, I'm going to sleep.
No. So,
are you guys going to set up watch for this night?
Hell yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay.
And now Godric's super sleep. Pissed, so he's super...
So which one do you want Weston to take?
I don't...
First watch. for sure.
Well, I don't want any of us to not be on watch. So, like, before we break up and go tell them the plan, I say we're doing watch tonight, and one of us is on watch.
We all do watch. We do three shifts. It's been a long time since we've done it.
But. Right, but what I'm saying is, like, if Weston or one of them want to help, they can help, but I'm not having them watch by themselves.
With them, that's all that matters.
Right.
So, like, if one of us goes, and then 3 hours later somebody else goes, and 3 hours later somebody else goes.
Right. All I'm trying to say is that I don't trust the were-spiders enough yet to have them.
You don't trust them enough, but they're going to live in your keep.
That's my plan. It's awesome.
And I just walk off. I said, I'm on first watch, bitches. And I just walk off in the darkness.
All right, I'll take third or fourth watch.
Like to, I need some sleep.
She'd like to ask Gaggy why his fingers glow yellow.
Whose?
Adriana asks you that. She goes, I don't mean to be too personal, but why do your fingers glow yellow?
Yeah, well...
That's personal. That's what you should say.
I got a little excited in the heat of battle, and I decided to go after a tasty, what was it, like an elephant, bull, mastodon heart? I don't know what that animal was, but it was a nasty animal.
It was a buffalo. It was a zombie buffalo.
Yeah, so I did not know how zombie this buffalo was, but apparently it was full on zombie.
I didn't know how
zombie-ish,
but full on zombie. Okay, there's newly infected.
Not like sort of zombie, but sort of not. It's the same, but not the same.
There's a spectrum of zombie that you can land in, right? So like you can be on the lower end where you're not full there. You know, you're pretty close, but you're not all there. And then there's like this upper end where it's like, holy shit, that's a zombie. And one way to find out apparently is when you eat the fucking heart.
So wait, is this like iZombie versus like Walking Dead zombie? Like, I don't know where we're at on this. Like,
yeah, because Carl like, doesn't know this
like
one either.
Zombie yeah. Land, or is this like?
Yeah, this was pretty serious zombie car. This was. But you know, I tell you what.
Knew it. Never mind. I don't want to know. Don't even.
Tell you
I don't
what. Zombie buffaloes make the tastiest hearts.
I just want to let everyone know. I'm gonna recap.
Hold on. I want to understand this correctly. Did you just say a zombie buffalo makes the tastiest heart?
Yeah, man, that shit was good. Why do you think my hands are all glowing and shit, man? I was digging.
So you ate a zombie's heart, right? Okay.
No, zombie buffalo.
Oh, I'm sorry. let's clarify. Sorry, my bad.
An undead buffalo's heart. Yep.
So you ate something that's undead that doesn't need a heart to be, to live.
Well, like I said,
Hold on.
I didn't know how zombie it was, right?
I'm getting there.
He thought it was so
sure. I mean, my race has been around a while, but I'm pretty sure if they said zombie, they mean there's no difference. No blood is pumping through that heart, so you just literally ate a rotten heart.
It was. I'm telling you, man, it was tasty. And you know what? Like those zombie buffalo hearts, like they pump through a lot more than you think, man. I had that blood all over me and everything.
Uh huh.
I was like, look, right here. What do you think this is, car?
About this time, Geiger comes back and explains the car.
Doing something.
He explains the car. You're trusting the man that doesn't trust someone to go live in his keep. And he's eating zombie buffalo hearts. Do you understand how fucking crazy this guy is?
Plan's perfect. I love it.
It's perfect. It's fucking brilliant.
No, what you don't understand, Godric, is that zombie buffalo hearts are really high in vitamin B12, which is actually really good for your brain.
I ain't one with you.
Really? You sure?
Yep, absolutely. I'm sure we've known this for centuries. You know, there are many, many wizards back in the day that have tested which hearts are the best for your brain. I've read it in books. I've read many, many books in my time.
Okay. Hey, Helen. All right. Helenor, you're going to lie down in bed and you find something kind of poking you in the back. It's not real comfortable.
Is he lying next to Carr?
Excuse me. Nobody's asked me my sexual orientation yet. So don't just assume that I like eagles.
You are a dragon. You're into flying things, right? It doesn't matter.
It's true. This is true.
I'm a dragon born. Does that mean I like flying creatures, thank you? It could just mean I like
poking him in the back.
Yeah, that's right.
Mm-hmm. You have a sixth deck. Mm.
This session has devolved so bad. It's hilarious. Fucking, oh my god.
Okay. So Carr is not poking you in the back, by the way.
Like, oh, no,
literally or figuratively.
Okay, so I'll reach. I'm no better. I'm going to reach behind and see what it is.
Well, look, you come out with a dagger that kind of has a weird kind of shape and a lot of gems on the handle.
What? Yes! What?
How is hard is knocking around you? This, guys?
Oh. Holy
shit.
That's I get right it. There. I know where it came from, but I'm not there, so I don't see it. So,
yeah.
No. So, not going to meta.
Who is it me around me that sees this, or what?
You guys are all just getting ready for bed, so you're all kind of awake. If any of you want to roll your, anybody who gets higher than a 15 on their 20, if you'd like to roll, go for it.
Bam!
Ooh. Okay. Real life Skaggy knows where this shit came from.
Is this with our perception?
Yeah.
Fucking, I see it too, bitch.
It's mine. You better back up. I will crush you like the maggot you are.
I'm sitting, by the way, Godric's on first watch, so he's sitting on one of the chests, and his legs are, like, kicking, like, the chest, you know, just like a little fucking school kid. Just like, fucking, like, you know, he's just chilling, and he sees this.
I didn't know you were part leprechaun, man.
Yeah, dude. Fucking magically delicious.
In a bondage suit.
I'm on the chest going like this. This is the best.
Sir Godric saw it. Retosh, did you? What's your perception? No. Do you have a bonus? No?
I don't think so.
Skaggy
rolls an 18.
So Carr sees it. So Skaggy. Does Godric.
The two people that should have seen it have seen it.
Skaggy is basically asleep.
Oh, you shouldn't have seen it. Rita should have seen it. That's who should have seen it. I got to remember that I'm mirrored on your screen so I know where to point. All the time I'm like, oh, wait, let me poke. Oh, that's the wrong direction. Crap.
You're down there.
So, Helenor, you're standing there and you kind of pull out this dagger and you're kind of like looking at it so you could see it in the firelight. It's pretty fancy looking dagger. And you catch a glimpse of it, and so does Carr.
And all you hear from me is, where did you find that?
I just turn around, oh, I don't know, it's right behind me. I'm not sure where it came from.
Oh my goodness.
That is awesome. Please tell me some of my other stuff is around here.
Is this yours? I don't even know what this is. This...
No, that's not.
The dagger that the queen spider gave me.
Are you sure it's a dagger? What's end of the pointy end? I'm not really sure how this works.
Of course you're not. He gently goes, puts his finger on his lips and goes, shh.
Worry about it. I got this.
And I say, hey, Carr, considering there's only one, you know, it's useless without the other one, so I'll just take this.
How do you know it's useless without the other one? You don't know shit about the other one.
I know there were two.
You know there were two, but you don't know what they're for.
I just like the pretty, okay? I don't give a shit what they're for.
There's another one, and it looks just like it. Because I found them when we were down in the nest.
Spider caves.
Yeah, the spider caves. The spider nest or whatever you want to call it, yeah.
So Ritosh and Skaggy, you're probably hearing the conversation and seeing...
And Ritosh can verify that I saw that I had
those are cars.
Yeah, see, I know that the mirrored thing. You gotta like remember.
I say, but there's only one of them. There's not two of them.
So?
So you said you had two. There's only one.
Well, maybe the other one's laying around here somewhere.
Maybe this isn't your daggers.
So maybe then, you should shut up before I make you.
So hearing there's more than one of them, this is not made of natural elements. I have no interest in it. It looks nice, whatever. So I throw it to Carr, and I lay down back on the ground, start rolling around, see if something else pokes me.
Tell me something else. Always
that is amazing.
And you have to roll your...
I see Halinor literally going in a sleeping bag and just going, hey guys, let's see what's going on.
And he gets a jewel dagger in the ass.
So anybody else can roll 20-sided. Everybody can if they want, but you need a 20 on this roll.
Ooh. For what? What is this for?
Oh. Just,
dang.
How do I get two ones? What the...
Oh no! Motherfucker!
Fucking right, dude.
Oh man. Hey. Hilarious.
Give me my fucking prize.
I have did I have to roll a 20 or does I get a 20 with bonus? Is okay.
This one was a 20-20.
Oh.
So let's see. I'm gonna send this one in
No, you can't do that.
Got to figure out how can I get a message to... I'll use Hangouts
Hangout.
Here.
Hangouts, yeah.
Hey, Odin, share your desktop.
Do you want to see? Do you want to see what's going on? Do you want to see? Oh, shit. Fucking
everything. And he broke it.
It's cause the fucking Windows nope. has the bullshit where it
You just don't know how to use your computer, we know.
No, where you shake it back and forth between monitors, it will minimize everything.
Yeah.
Oh, it is gonna pop up right here though. Fuck. You guys gotta read it really fast.
Hold on up right here. I'm here, I'm ready.
Did you see it?
I haven't heard anything.
Yeah, I haven't heard anything yet.
Patrick?
Oh, he clicked on it, so it's up already. So we can't.
I don't see. You sent it in Hangouts? In
just
here?
Just to you. Yeah.
Just do it in the main one, Kelly. It's not a big deal. Yeah, we won't look.
Yeah, no. I haven't seen anything,
Kelly. Look. I'm not going to lie.
You didn't put anything in that.
You see that? You see the hello now?
Yep, I see it. But you... Okay. Gotcha.
He found the other jeweled one, dude. He's going to be in. Jerk like that, Kelly. Thanks.
I feel
maybe like... maybe he got a nice set of ball gags and nipple clamps to go with these.
I have no idea what just happened.
Kelly's nice, but not that nice.
Okay. I can't believe I just fucking rolled it, dude. That's amazing.
You know what? I hope that's the only 20 you get all night. The rest are going to be one, you fucker.
So everyone goes to sleep.
You go to tell the people that you're agreeing to take them to the keep, right?
No, no. I want to talk to Adriana first about how they build their nest. Like, what? Like, is it always underground, or was that just because they were there? They've been there for a long time, or like, what's going on with that?
No, it doesn't always have to be underground.
Do they prefer it?
They like to remain isolated. They like to keep their secret. They're hoping that you guys will honor their secret. Also, I mean, that's part of, if you agree to that they can live there, then they also want you to honor their secret. They will help you and be good citizens and do what they can to help you in the community and in the keep. But primarily, they just want to have a safe place to raise those kids.
I'm standing by next to Carr as he's talking about this, and I pat him on the shoulder and say, I'm...
Wait, hold on, stop right there. You patted me on the shoulder?
Yeah, good point. It's like your lower back.
Yeah. It's his ass. Like, he's doing the shocking ass.
That's what I give him a shocking.
Look at him and be like, "Quit playing grab ass."
I give him a shocking grasp of understanding, and say that tell them the plan that you came up with, and I'm gonna go lay down and rest.
Yeah. So, I mean, so like, you know, do you want me to say the plan again, or do you remember it, Kelly?
You were gonna. When you get to the keep, you're going to show them the.
Well, we're going to have
the outer entrances and have them build off of that or something. Yeah. So, are you all planning on going?
No, we're back to with Mia, because let's face it, I don't care who they are. She's going to fuck them up if they try to fuck with her.
Yeah, I mean, I say
not. She's going to fuck them up.
I say we have Jess go, right? So, like, Jess goes with them, and then we tell Jess where we're going so Jess can come back and meet us.
So, Skaggy?
Hold on. I was going to ask about Jess. Was Jess wanting to just to get out of town and, like, go somewhere else, or was he going to be part of our group now?
Well,
everybody. I mean, I just want to make sure, because I was confused on that. For a second,
I think Jess is good to be with us, but you know, Jess has to decide that too, right?
Yeah. So that's what where we're gonna offer him, like, hey, like, you know, do you want to come with us, or do you want to stay with like all the kids and everything and his girlfriend?
I'm gonna recommend that they have a transport, right? Because Galen could have sent somebody, for all we know, somebody that raid party could have been sent to the keep, you know? Like, we have no idea what direction they are.
Oh, I didn't think about that.
Yeah, like, somebody needs to go with, and I think we all need to go back on our regular mission. So, like, I would recommend that Jess go down. Jess takes whatever time he needs to recover at the keep, and then... tries to meet back up with us. He'll be a few days behind, but...
Now, it's Jess and his girlfriend. Are they going to be living in the keep, or are they going to have to stay out with the
There's room for them. There's room for them.
Just a thought. So we're saying children...
Well, I mean, okay, are we going to let them...
To a keep...
Those children could probably be five times stronger than you. Shut up.
Those kids are going to kick your ass.
Like, we're trying to go get this sword to protect the keep, and we're sending these people to a keep that is going to be attacked.
Yeah, we're building our other entrance. Exactly.
That's what Vinny does on a dice roll.
Hey, we're building an army, and you need to shut up.
Exactly.
If we're going to be housing them, they're going to contribute and sacrifice their lives to save the keep if we need them to.
And Adriana just said that they would help us out. So.
Yep.
I like this.
And yet, I think
I like. I'm starting to like
just
the
to stay there.
Sorry, go ahead.
I think we just tell Jess to stay there.
I think so too. I think that would be good. Plus, then that also gives them another person to help protect the keep.
Yep.
Not Skaggy. That do it by yourself, but
Mobius is asking for a little of your time.
Uh oh.
So I say you guys got this stuff under control. I'm gonna go cozy up and lay down because I'm not on first watch. I tell everybody that I can't go on first watch. I gotta rest and get all my spells back. I have zero spell slots.
What's a spell slot?
A spell slot is a spell that like is, you know, really, really excited and like to be a spell and like getting themselves out there, you know, and like trying to get with all the wizards that they can.
Gotcha. It's like the Tinder of spells.
Gotcha. Oh, wait, spell slot. Sorry, slot. S-L-O-T, sorry.
Oh, sorry. My bad.
Does everyone go to sleep?
No.
One of us is going on watch.
I'll stay on watch.
I'll do first watch.
Can you help me get my chest plate on?
Yep.
It takes a little bit of time.
Yeah, I'll help you.
You want to get that
up before I go back to sleep.
You don't want to wear that while you're sleeping.
I will sit up. Okay. That's true. I probably don't
sleep
want to
first.
Wear it. Yeah, I'll sleep first.
And then I'm going to go through what I found, Kelly. Okay.
So what is I'm laying down now, kind of, you know, a little secluded with my ring kind of, you know, up to my face. What's going on with Mobius here?
He says there's a message from the Prince of Ulic for you at the keep. You need to return.
What, can you tell me what the message is?
I can't read it from here.
This is a good try, though.
I'm trying to like hold back and stay calm here a little bit. Well, how did you know there was a message in the first place?
I'm a magical ring.
Fucking Mobius and Grinkle, dude. I love them. They're just like, they do what the fuck they want to all the time. Just whatever they want to do. Kelly's like, oh, fuck it, the story's not working. Mobius is going to fix this shit right now. I fucking love it, dude. I love it.
I say, Mobius, what about this, like, sword that we're supposed to be getting?
Who's talked about a sword?
Weren't you the one who told me about the sword in the first place?
Oh, I told you there was a tomb where you might be able to find something. I don't know anything about a sword.
Okay, so there is a message for me back at the keep.
Yeah.
Okay. So I'm trying to think right now if I bother telling everybody now or in the morning.
Just wait till morning.
Yeah. I'm kind of thinking I'll let everybody rest.
So
I'm like, Mobius, you better help me convince everybody else because I don't want a pissed off party at me, all right?
Hold on. Are the only people that know Mobius exists me and you?
Yep.
Yeah.
I thought so. Okay. Just throwing that back out there.
So all you have to say to Godric is Mobius.
So you guys are...
Mobius.
You guys are allowed to have your suspicions about what's going on, and you've seen some weird shit, right? So You don't.
Eleanor's seen your uncle.
Yeah, dude, I hear you talking to yourself, and I know who you're talking to. Even though I act like Mobius doesn't exist, from what you know, I know what's going on.
I think you got to roll a perception check, because I was being pretty quiet, man, and I was, like, laying on my side and shit.
No, he's just asking because
he was like,
because when you tell the story in the morning,
it's off the screen. I think
Stephen Bag by himself.
I think that natural one begs to differ with your perception that you're describing to us.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Is that what you were saying, Odin? That you could hear him, or I thought you were saying something else?
No, I just see him like whispering to what appears to be himself, and I just kind of know what's happening.
Yeah. Yeah.
Like, I notice he's not talking to anybody. There's, like, nobody around him, and he's, like, whispering to himself. It's a little fucking weird. and you're over
just
in
saying
the files
knows what
going,
you're doing.
Wow, oh, it was in here, like, looking through documents and shit. And Kelly, I don't know if you saw my ping or not, but...
All right, so anything else, Kelly, or we sleep? I'm rolling a hit die. Actually, a hit die wouldn't really do me any good, but I'm just resting.
Okay.
This be a long rest for three watches?
Yeah.
Okay.
It'll be a long rest, so you get you get half of the total hit dice that you can have back. So that's basically... At your level, if you're three, it's ones. You get one hit dice back.
So can we use one to get it back immediately?
Yes.
Okay. I would like to do that then.
You get all your spells back.
All our spells back, okay. And then I basically have to decide what spells I'm going with, right?
All right.
Yes, you do.
You find a, it's a letter addressed to Arden Galen that is an agreement to purchase spider eater eggs for 2,000 gold pieces each.
Wait, who? What?
But you can't quite read the name of who sent it.
Don't you have a treasure chest full of more than 2,000 gold pieces?
Whatever, man. You can always use more gold. What the fuck? 2,000 is a lot. What's wrong with
billions
you?
Of dollars in gold, right?
Bro? Dude, we already have these two chests that are filled. Why is it fucking bad? You know what I mean?
I think having our own spire eaters is much, much cooler than 2,000 credits or whatever, gold.
We transported our D&D to the future.
You upgraded from horse to spider eater.
Yeah, there you go. Yeah.
Spider. Anything else, Kelly?
Yes, you also found a note that seems to be from the Pomarch that is putting a bounty on any merchants or caravans that are looted inside Uluk.
So like the pirate?
And Tarashis Mok appeared like he was paying Galen a bounty for any merchants or caravans that they raided within Uluk.
That motherfucker.
So he was paying them to loot people?
Tarashis Mok is, yes.
Who's this Tarashis Mok?
He's one of the major warlords in the Pomarch.
Did you write that down, Odin?
Yeah.
Okay.
I got my fucking notebook, dude. Don't
worry. All right, I know. You're the notekeeper.
Yeah.
Anything else? Anything else good, Kelly?
So,
What he was wearing was studded leather armor, which you guys took. He has a... He had a chainmail shirt. He had a small shield and a longsword. And he had a crossbow. He had a belt pouch that had 18 platinum pieces and 20 gold.
Holy shit. That is a lot, right? Like, I should be saying holy shit on that, right? Nobody else had a reaction, so...
Platinum is 180
gold. Again, we got a whole chest of stuff, so whatever.
Yeah, I know, but still, we don't know what's exactly in our chest, but still 18 platinum? That's still pretty fucking awesome. No?
I'm not gonna let us keep these two fucking full things of treasure, guys. Just an assumption, okay?
Remember, I was the guy paid to protect caravans. I was not making 18 platinum.
Actually, that's a good point. Well, we're going to talk about this, but, I mean, I want to... Maybe we do need to want to go to the keep first, take it there.
Well,
so that we can take the chest, too, there.
I suggest we buy a very special item that Kelly has not introduced to us yet, because he's a bastard that we need... So we can have our treasure on us.
So, real quick before we go forward, you said it's studded leather armor?
That was chain. Sorry.
Oh, chain armor. Okay, never mind.
Chain armor.
Well, you can't wear that, Alagor?
No. It's not.
It's a medium armor, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, chain's medium.
I could wear it, but the guy is human size.
You don't want. You're happy. You're way too happy with what you have. So,
he's excited.
It's a really bad piece of armor, but I do not have to heal myself, so it's really nice.
Yeah. Skaggy, can Skaggy wear it?
No.
Yeah, who can wear it? Let's start there.
You. Carr could wear it. Well. It might be a little small for Carr. I would think Halinor could wear it, or Ritosh could wear it, but it probably wouldn't fall under his...
I don't need no stinking armor.
Right. Halinor could physically wear it, but it doesn't fall under his... I think Godric could, except it would be a dress on him. And
what about, like,
he could wear it, but Godric, he couldn't cast spells while he was wearing it.
Grinkle, can he wear it?
Grinkle has full plate, dude.
No, he doesn't.
He doesn't. No.
No, Grinkle? What's Grinkle wearing? I think he's wearing studded. He could probably wear it.
Yeah.
Wouldn't that increase his armor?
Definitely.
Okay, and then would that also... I mean, would that hinder him in any ability? Like, would that hinder him anyway, or would that just be he's more protected?
Well, let's see what he has real quick.
Yes. What?
He's wearing studded leather. And I think he'd rather keep the studded leather than the chain.
Okay.
You could always sell it.
Sold. Well, can Jesse wear it or anything? Like,
you also found a small lockbox. And... It looks like it was the lock was already broken on it. Going through it, and Ritosh is the one going through this. He finds inside the bigger box, there's a smaller lock box that has felt lining, and there's two vials inside of it.
Ooh.
There's also a map of the local forest.
Anything interesting on that?
It shows the outsides of it are badly burned, but it appears to show the entrance for the nest.
Mm.
You also see a little packet of funny-looking tools. They're short wires with little hooks on the end. There's also five little ivory statues.
Anything, like, do they look the same? Do they look different?
They look almost like, you're guessing they're depictions of five different gods. They're small. They're only about as tall as your finger. But they are made from ivory. And very detailed.
You're spinning something metal.
I think that was the chaotic wizard.
No, it was me. What's the vials? What color are they, Kelly?
Blue.
Good.
Hold on to that.
Yeah. Especially if you're going to try to wrangle some of these.
You know I am. That's not even a question.
And Grinkle made omelets for breakfast. Wait, no.
Boom shakalaka.
It's fucked up, Kelly. Killing every goddamn animal I come across.
He's making a point.
So,
no pets for John.
When Kelly says no, he means it.
No, I'm about to go pee on this GM's ass. That's what I'm about to do. Fucking throwing blood on you next time I see you.
So, how are we doing on time? It is a little after 10, and it's that much later for Eleanor.
Yeah, I think we can call it here after you answer my question.
Oh, what's that?
Look at your chat.
Oh. Let me look at the chat.
Because I'm assuming we go through watch and nothing happens, but something does happen before Geiger goes to sleep.
Yeah, like we get all of our experience points.
Also true.
Wow, this must be a hard contemplation for Kelly.
Yeah. One other thing I want to check.
This could be super weird, dude. I have to do this in secret because you guys would not know. None of you would. Because you're sleeping. And Ritosh is counting his platinum.
No, I'm going to split it with the group, man. I'm going to tell everybody once we wake
up. No, I know. I'm just letting you know.
No, he's not. He's lying. No, I'm just kidding.
He's like, kidding. You said, how much platinum? 18? Guys, I got 2 platinum. I don't know what happened. All of a sudden, we go back to town. Ritosh is like, I got this new weapon and this new armor.
Look at this clock necklace.
You're like,
it's a grandmother clock necklace.
Where did the other chest of gold go? What other chest of gold? I don't know what you're talking about. What's it burned up in the fire? Shit, I don't know.
Yeah, that's Skaggy's burning hands.
Ooh. My only thing is there's no way that a
roll
fire
20 for me.
Entire town.
Adric.
Roll 20? Alright.
Yes, please.
Come on. This better be high. Fuck!
I don't know what I'm doing. I'm happy that it wasn't high.
Do I get deception with that? Or performance? Can I get performance with that, Kelly?
Still, it's not enough.
That performance, I'd give you stealth. which is what you're really trying to do, which is plus athletics? 4.
Would that work?
Would what?
Would athletics work? Oh, stealth would work. It still only gives me like an 8.
Yeah.
Well, plus 4. So, hold on, I'm at plus 4. I'm at 10. Because it's a dex, and then I have my level rounded down. So plus 5. So yeah, I'm at 11.
Mm-hmm. And so this is, I'm just going to describe it to the others, if that's all right.
That's fine.
So Godric wakes up and is crawled over quietly through camp and is starting to look through Grinkle's pack.
Oh.
And all of a sudden, Grinkle goes, "You need something? I help you?" Cheese over in the side pocket.
And I'm like Grinkle, shh, shh, shh. So, you know, I'm like, "Hey, you know, there's this dagger I lost, and I think you might know something about it."
He giggles and goes, "You not get the other jeweled dagger."
Kelly, the hard ass.
He giggles and rolls back over.
Couldn't have rolled a 14.
I rolled good.
God damn it. So everyone knows he has the other fucking dagger now.
Godric knows.
God damn it.
Well, I knew as soon as that dagger showed up, I knew exactly where they came from.
Where did they come from?
I don't know. He's sleeping. Okay. So, yeah, we go through watch. Unless anything happens, Kelly, I suggest we break there and pick up next time.
I'm going to go ahead and move it forward just a little bit.
Okay.
You guys do make it. You guys, the next morning, you guys head up and pack out and head back toward the keep. You don't run into any problems. When you get there, I'm going to go ahead and give you guys experience points for the next time. You will have made levels, all of you. So go ahead and read whatever books you have. And if you want, you can talk to me during the week. And we'll try and get the main thing I think all of you will get. If you want, we can talk about this offline too. But basically, we're going to start the next time at the keep. So
okay, we're basically fully healed at this point, right?
Yeah, you'll get back to the keep, be fully healed.
Sweet, I like that.
Cool.
I'm going to just move it along a little bit that way. So
it's fine.
Starting in a new chapter, if you will.
Cool.
Not much of a cliffhanger this time, but I think it'll have a good start next time.
Cool.
Tell you.
So okay. I think we're out.
All right. Everyone, thank you for watching. Post this to YouTube. And we almost got away with a fucking jeweled dagger without anybody knowing. But.
Sucker!
Kelly's a master. And.
No, you just suck at rolling.
Should I have had advantage on that one, Kelly? I mean, really? I was sneaking, I was being stealthy. Fuck.
Hey, you don't
still be enough.
I was singing a song. I was like beating my bongo drum when I was like trying to sneak in this pack or something.
You're like,
"Hey, can anybody hear me? I'm not doing anything I'm not supposed to be."
You're trying to steal from the guy who's running the game. So
shut up.
That's basically what you were doing.
Yeah, pretty much.
I fucking know.
I rolled an 18.
Hello.
I got a good roll. You rolled an 18? Yeah, you were not going to beat that.
Damn it.
Yeah, you burned up his 20 already.
I think Godric, I even rolled it where Godric can see it.
Did you? Oh, on the,
are we out?
On the board? Yeah. All right. Nice. Anyway, thanks for watching. Good session. We won't be here next week, right, Kelly? So, week after, maybe. We'll see.
I think that was John.
No, I thought you were camping.
It was up to John.
The 16th. Aren't you camping next week?
Week after.
Oh, the week after.
Week after, I'm camping. Oh, okay. Not next week, week after.
I will be there next week.
So maybe next week. I don't know. We'll see.
Okay.
Stay tuned. Thanks for watching. Have a good night.